I believe it's best if it comes from the man directly. Oh. So, I would like to say, we have with us tonight, Dr. Hahn.
Hi, Dr. Hahn.
Hello.
Good evening.
How are you? How are you, Doctor?
Hey, I'm doing really well, Anthony. How about you?
Oh, God willing, we're all doing good. Thank God, we're having wonderful classes. Tonight is our last class, so we're a little sad about that.
Well, I understand that, but all the people there at St. Rita's have been going to the Bible and the Sacraments. I'm really grateful for the opportunity to express my greetings, but also my gratitude for you sticking with us. And Anthony, I hope you get a chance to make for them tomato sauce as good as the one that you made.
Oh, I'm coming back in July, so you'll have to put your order in soon.
You got it. We're putting it in right now.
How is Kimberly? Everybody wonderful?
She's doing very well. She couldn't be with me right now because the city council meeting started 4 minutes ago downtown.
She is a newly elected public official in her area, so
that's right.
She's going to bring blessings to that part of town.
What that was talk.
That's wonderful. While we have Dr. Hahn, and he's a very hard man to capture like this, does anybody have a question that they might want to ask him? Yes, Maxine.
Maxine,
I'm going to move the camera a little, Doctor, so you can see some of the other people here. Go right ahead, Maxine.
So I was thinking about this earlier. I had a conversation with a friend of mine yesterday about the languages that were around during Jesus' time. Do you happen to know the different languages that were around when Jesus left?
The different languages. I don't know if you heard that, Dr. Hahn.
Yes, I did. You know, as you think about the passion narrative, you recall that the plaque that was over Jesus' head there, cross of Calvary, that is known as the Titulus, that was actually written in Hebrew, Greek, and Latin. Now, why? About 30 years ago, we didn't think that people in Palestine could really speak Greek. But what we've discovered in the last 20 years or so, from a number of sources, is that most likely, most Jews could speak Greek as well as Aramaic or Hebrew, and that many of them would have been familiar with Latin, at least in the basics. And so that's why the Titulus over Jesus' head there at the cross is in three languages. And Jews have never been uneducated people. And so the fact is, it looks as though the languages that were used in Palestine back then would have been Greek as well as Hebrew, but by Hebrew, I mean Aramaic. Anyway, it's so good to see all of you in the same place. I hope you've enjoyed the Bible and the Sacraments. I know you've enjoyed Anthony because he is one live liar.
All right. Well, I'm pushing the Scooterville conferences on them. Trying to see if I can take the bus load.
End of July, we have those two back to back. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, the last week of July, we have the Applied Biblical Studies. And we're going to be focusing on Luke, the Gospel of Mercy, for the year of mercy. And then as soon as that is over on Friday morning, Friday afternoon, we have the Friends of Faith. And that's an exciting conference. We're expecting 1,500, close to 2,000 people. And the song and prayer and worship is about to raise the roof. It's really fun.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, great.
So we'll see if we can recruit some, and then next year I'll be an ambassador and bring a busload over.
Absolutely. So you're going to be back here?
What's that?
Are you going to be back here in the 2nd of July then?
Yes, I am. I'm coming for both ABS and Defending the Faith.
Excellent. It'll be great to see you. Hey, would you mind if I opened your evening time together in a word of prayer?
We would love that. Absolutely.
Let's unite our hearts in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, our Father in heaven, we thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ, especially now in Passion Week, and especially now at the end of the study in the Bible and the Sacraments. I thank you for my brothers and sisters at St. Rita's, and for the time and energy that they devoted to the study of your covenant faithfulness. I also thank you for my brother Anthony, and for the way that he has really partnered with us at the St. Paul Center to get the word out. But above all, we thank you, Father, for the fact that you have given us your word, and that word has become flesh to dwell among us, to die for us, rise again. And we ask in his name for the Holy Spirit to pour out upon these people, your beloved sons and daughters, this evening, that you would write upon their hearts the truths of your word, that these sacraments would no longer be rituals that we do for you, but these would be mysteries that you do for us and in us for other people as well. Help us then and hear us as we pray that family prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Saint Rita,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you so much, Dr.
Thank you.
We'll see you soon. You're always in our prayers. We have prayer for your mom on All Souls Day, so your whole family is always in our prayers.
I am most grateful, Anthony. God bless you all.
God bless you.